up off of that thing and dance to you. You better get up off of that thing and dance to you. Say it now. Get up off of that thing and dance to you. You better get up off of that thing and try to release that pressure. Get up off of that thing and shake to you. You better get up off of that thing and shake to you.
Bam! Hey kids, welcome back. We got a special one going on now. I told you guys a while back that we had a couple special videos coming up. And one of those videos, which is now this, is what I'm going to call Project Condor, all right? Yes, JJ RotoGeek is going to be making something that flies, hopefully, again. I got some quad stuff. I've just been putting it off. But anyway, this is a special, very special project for me. This is a project that my buddy Patrick down in Kentucky and myself, it was his idea, but he conjured it up and we're kind of splitting it. He bought some of the bits, a lot of the bits, actually more than I did, and then I bought some guts and I'm doing the build. So that's kind of the trade-off. So I'm building two of these, one of which is going to be this build video. Now, it's not going to be a build video, it's going to be a build it, show you guys what we did, go over it, da-da-da-da. But this is a very unique GPS drone wing, all right? Now, I've got a couple drone wings. I've got one over there, I've got one hanging from the ceiling, and you guys probably see my black drone wing. I absolutely love it. Now, the reason I call them drone wings is because they are running GPS, they're running a quadcopter flight controller, they have return to launch, they have programmability, so I can program it to go somewhere, have it go there, make a couple loops, fly home or land. If you get into trouble or whatever, it's basically autopilot, like a GPS drone quad. Flip a switch, it does return to home, comes home, and I have mine circle above your head, and I have used this many, many times. All of my fixed wings are set up this way, believe it or not. My airplanes, yeah, my P-51s, all my warbirds, believe it or not, are GPS drones, because I don't trust myself, I get lost in the sky. So, this is a project, again, very near and dear to my heart. It's kind of like the Miss Roto Geek boat build, but this is with my buddy Pat. And what we're going to do is once these things are done, we're going to meet in the middle, or I'm going to go to his place or wherever we end up, and we're going to do a video flying these things together. These are long-range GPS drone wings. Okay? Now, recently I found out that my brother Patrick and his family are going through some, actually found out last night, some trying health issues. And so I ask for all your prayers for them, that they pull through and get this situated and knocked out. And I know they will. They'll get it knocked out right out of the park, and everybody will be healthy, happy, and drinking again. So, but anyway, so say a prayer for my buddy Pat and his family. But anyway, so we're going to get on with this. What's going in these? You're thinking, okay, whoop-de-fuck, dude. A drone wing. You've done like three of those, right? Not like this. We're calling this Project Condor. Okay, it's going to be multiple videos. This is the first one. Going to be no builds in this video. This one's just going to be to get our feet wet. So, I am building both of these differently. Patrick's, my buddy's, he's is going to be the second one I build. It will probably not be in the video. I'll show you guys the finished product, but the first one's going to be mine. That way, if I fuck anything up, which I don't think I will, it's on my bird, and then I can kind of perfect it and do his even better. So I'm going to show you the guts that are going in his, well, most of them. I am putting in a Maytag F4022, or is it an F7? It might be an F7. I can't remember. I don't have it on my bench, but it's a flight controller that's got all the bells and whistles that we will need for iNav. iNav is the firmware that drones use, not quadcopters. Well, I mean, it can be quads, but drones, GPS guided crap, right? So we're going to put a Maytag F722 in his, I think. We're going to be using in Pat's as well the new, what is this fucking thing? Foxeer, Falcor. Woohoo, sounds fancy. Mine is not getting this nice of a camera. This is a 1200, if I remember right, TVL. Oh, this fucking head cold's killing me. So this is it. This is the new Foxeer Falcor. whatever. This is it. Beautiful camera. This one I got for his. I am putting in a mini Predator in mind, and it's brand new, but just because I already had it, it's still brand new in the box, so I'm going to give my buddy the really nice one. We are putting in, dumbass, Furious FPV 800 milliwatt VTXs. Never used them before in my life. Hopefully they're worth a shit. We are then putting in TBS. Gave TBS a lot of money for this gig. Crossfire Micro TX. Supposedly, this is going to go in the back of our Tyrannuses. Supposedly, this is going to get us 40 kilometers, it says. Whatever. It's not going to get us 40 kilometers because I doubt we'll do that. For the plain simple fact, our video is not going to go 40 kilometers, but our video is going to go damn far. We're putting a GPS in this as well, and you don't need to see that. But here's the trick. Hang on. I ordered some toys for my buddies at Farview. Here's what we got. I ordered the monstrous 13-turn helical antennas. So what we're going to do, I'm actually going to do a separate build video on how to build, and I've already done build videos on these, and actually I ordered some stuff because I owe my buddy a couple of antennas, and if you're watching this, you know who you are, and I have not forgot. Well, I did forget, but I'm remembering now. So we're going to build some monster truck 13-turn helical antennas, so that's going to give us a fuck ton of range. My buddies at Farview, look at this. They gave me some free stuff. Right-hand circular power polarized. Look at the stubby. Fucking badass. Thank you, guys. I'm going to put Farview in the title of this just so you guys get a little bit of press. There's a left-hand circular, which is fine. I'll never use it. I'll give it away. And then here's the base. Look at this. Look at it. This thing. You could be up seeing Spock's asshole with these. This is going to be awesome. Thank you, Farview, for the extra toys. I love you guys. And I am putting your stickers on radio-controlled nitro cars now, and I am going to do a build video on this. Now, to give you an idea, I think it's a 13-turn. What was the other one? Hang on. Yeah, this one. 7-ish, 8-ish, 9-ish turn. So you can see this is huge, right? You can see clear the fuck out with this guy. Look at the difference. These things, son, you're going to get Skinamax on this motherfucker. This is going to be awesome. So now, without further ado, I want to show you something really cool. Hang on. Check that out. Whoopty shit. It's a 2017 Honda Civic. You guys have seen my car 1,000 times, but that's not really what I want to show you. Hang on. This is what I want to show you. That's my car, which is a 4-door hatchback. It's not that small. This is the fucking bird. This thing has it's an Optera Horizon Hobby, 6-foot wingspan. The thing is absolutely immense. I don't know how to get a better picture. Hang on. Ugh. Maybe that's a better representation of how big this bitch is. It is absolutely fucking phenomenal. It's heavy. I mean, for a wing, right? Hang on. Ugh. All right. So now I have to walk around the damn car. Shit. See, this is a fun video. We're gonna have fun with this. Sorry if you guys are getting some wind interference, about ready to storm. See that? Okay. So here we go. Put in my new 2-speed transmission, and I broke my pole start. Got to fix that. But anyway, so here it is, the Horizon Hobby Optera 6-foot wingspan folding doohickey prop. It is actually a plug and play, or no, a bind and fly, whatever. But we're getting rid of that shit because it's got, what are those pukey ass radios I don't like? Spectrum. Those things suck. I don't like them anyway. So check it out. Here's our bay. There's the Spectrum, and it's got safe technology. I'm going to affectionately take this out and flush it down the toilet because we're not using this shit. We're using TBS Crossfire. My buddy Patrick, I think, uses Spectrum, so I'll give them both back to him. The hatch is stellar. It's magnetic. You can see that right there. And it snaps in here, but it actually has a snap latch here. Check it out. Okay. Pops up.
Look at it. It is fucking badass. Look at all the room in there. So I'm gonna put my guts right here. Flight controller, GPS, all that stuff. A lot of plane guys put GPSs out on the wings, and they put all sorts of stuff out on the wings. You don't need to. I don't know why people do that. GPS will read through foam like that.
So I am not boring holes in the fucking wings of this bird. Just, that's gay. You don't need to do that. So, you can put a run cam.
I wouldn't use a run cam, but a camera here. It comes, I'm not going to show you because it's in the box, but it comes with a bunch of noses and nose weight for how you want to do it. You can put your, which is what we're going to do, I would think, at least I know I am. I don't know about my buddy Pat. I have to take these screws out to show you guys how this works, and I'm not going to bother with that because we'll see it in the build videos. Came with a bunch of different noses for a bunch of different options. And for putting your HD camera in here, we're gonna put our, probably I'm gonna make a 3D printed doohickey here for, I don't know, I haven't decided yet. We probably put the HD camera in here and the FPV gear here. I'll make a 3D print to make it nice and neat. Just fucking, this thing, I wish you guys could see it in person. This thing's just a bitch.
I don't even know what the hell this is. It's a little
thing, I don't know. We'll work it out. Antenna, maybe, antenna port. And 6 foot plane, and the wings pop off with these little doohickeys here. So you pull out the pin like a grenade. See if I can, I can't do this one. Hang on. Professional would edit that out. Okay. Carbon fiber rods, two of them, rather large. And then your wings plug in here for your servos, obviously. It's got the full size, what, 12 gram servos in there. Yeah, absolutely beautiful. And the wing tips come off with the same pin technique. So, very, very portable.
Folding prop in the back. I can't remember the specs. We'll go over the specs when I actually do the build so you guys can really figure it out. This is just an intro video of what we're going to be doing.
And, so I'll be able to get my cheesy ass little car and I'll be able to store it because I don't know how I am going to hang it in here, because as you can see, I got my huge P-51, I got my Miss Roto Geek, 3D printed Messerschmitt, which is just kind of floating there,
my Spitfire, my helicopter, my Trojan, drone wing, my buddy's dad's Pylon Nitro that we need to still do our shop on,
that thing, yeah, we got too much in all those things, obviously, so, yeah, Mama's gonna be pissed because I'm probably gonna hang it right there. And it's a little scary looking. But anyway, so it does come apart really, really well. The wing tips come off the same way. We're gonna do a couple little mods that you normally wouldn't do with a plane, okay? I'm not hydro dipping this or anything. I need to use the fucking bathtub. But what we're gonna do is I'm gonna try it on mine first. I did it on my black wing and it worked really well. I'm gonna use my epoxy trick and on the leading edges to give it a little bit more robustness for if we have rough landings, whatever. I'm gonna epoxy the wingtips for absolute sure. This epoxy that I use on the radio control cars and the Miss Roto Geek boats and things like that is EPO safe. So, cause I already did it on my black wing, works really, really well. It'll make this plane last for fucking ever. It's not a cheap machine. It's like $229, but it is a bind and fly. So if you have a Spectrum, God help you, yep. Plug it in, put in a 3000, I think it's a 3000 milliamp 3S, I think, don't quote me on that, throw it in the fucking air, which I haven't even figured out how to launch it yet, and there you go, Jack be nimble, there it goes, but we're definitely going to epoxy the wingtips to give them some longevity, maybe the leading edge, and whatever nose we decide to use. It came with a whole bag of noses and lead weights, very, very well thought out bird. The winglets here are also removable. They kind of lock in with the carbon fiber. So yeah, this thing's gonna be just fucking amazing. Now, the interesting thing, need a road twister, hang on. That's tight. The interesting thing about this project that I'm curious about, the reason it's unique is my smaller wings, like one is a meter wide, and my black one, I want to say is 900 millimeter wingspan, and I love that black one, but it's not real stable.
And I'm not flying in auto level when I fly. Usually I'm flying in, you know, normal modes. But, you know, it's just small and it gets knocked around. This thing's like flying a fucking 737. So, I mean, it's sitting there in the wind right now and it's going like this. I think it's going to be a really, really stable platform. But what I'm really curious to find out is these, my Farview monster truck antennas, because I want to see, I feel perfectly safe with the Crossfire from what I've read. I feel perfectly safe with my capabilities of using iNav and my return to launch, and if there's any problems whatsoever, if I go out of range, if I lose video signal, anything like that, I just flip a switch, wait a minute, and the bitch comes back. I'm not worried about that. What I'm curious to see is how these TBS, I mean, I don't care about these, but these are 800 milliwatt VTXs and a 13 turn helical work. I want to see how far those go out. That's going to be fucking cool. The other thing I want to try, I don't know when it's going to be. It's not going to be on the maiden or anything, but I want to program an iNav through the ground station. I would love to, after I figure out how long our flight time is, because if you notice the folding propeller in the back, you get this thing up to altitude, you kill the motor and just let it glide. It's basically a huge fucking glider. You've got a lot of wing surface area on this thing, so it's going to have tons of hang time. And you should get some monstrous, monstrous flight times out of it. I might do some, what I call, fake wind tunnel tests here in the garage. Put a brand new battery in it, let it bolt it down relative just the fuselage, and fly it at half throttle until the battery stops. Because that will give me a really good idea of how long my flight time is going to be. Because a lot of times you're not flying half throttle, a lot of times you're flying over half throttle. So half throttle is a really good range. I'll strap it to my little drum stool in here, or one of the motorcycles, and we'll just let it sit there for half an hour until the battery dies. And, well, you know, reasonably close. Because if this thing can make it to Black Hawk's house 25 miles away, what I'd really like to do is program it to fly over there. But that's neither here nor there. We'll worry about that later. We got a lot of testing to do, a lot of building to do, but that is it. Bam! So it's really not going to take me much longer to build this than it does any other wing. Actually, even less, because I don't have to fuck with servos. I don't have to fuck with the motor. I don't have to fuck with the ESC, any of that stuff. All I've got to do is take that thing apart, put the fuselage on the bench, do my business, set it up on iNav, bam, pop the wings on, and there we go. So it's, I don't think it's going to be a ton of videos, maybe 3 or 4 as far as the build goes. And yeah, it's going to be badass. So Operation or Project Condor is coming soon. So, and matter of fact, it'll be this week. Absolutely no doubt in my mind. And then once I build mine, I'll build Pat's, and then bam, we're going to be ready to rock and roll. So until the next time, kids, look over your houses. There might be a big fucking fat ass wing flying over it. Take care. Bye. Gangnam Style.